Welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, we'll be making an attachment that fits on a dial indicator so you can measure the runout of a bore without changing the dial indicator. This attachment fits on the end of the indicator spindle. It clamps on and it can swivel into position when you need to check a bore. It's got a bore bearing on the top that's soldered on, a shaft and a locking screw so you can lock it in position. So let's go into the workshop and see how we make it. I've just put a piece of silver steel in the lathe. Turning this down to 5mm. I've just fitted my radius attachment on to the cross slide by removing the compound slide. This fits into the compound slide dovetail. I've just set the tool to give me a radius. So what I'm going to do is bring this up to the bar so I can get a touch on it there. Move it in until I get it touching the edge. I just want to blend this sharp corner in here with the radius.
Now I've finished the centre drill hole and that holds this 5mm ball bearing, and as long as the shaft is below 5mm you know that it will touch the side of the ball. The next thing I need to do is put my indexing fixture on and make two flats on this shaft here, ready to drill some cross holes. So I'll set my fixture up and we'll mill the flats on.
I fitted the indexing fixture in the tool post, squared it up, put the workpiece in the indexing fixture, and in the headstock I've put the end mill. I just want to machine a flat on each side of this part and a flat on the top. I'm going to index it round turn it 90 degrees. I've got to drill a hole through this side and a hole through this side and tap it 3 millimeters. So I've put my center drill in. What I'm doing is just touching the center drill on the side of the part, using the feeler gauge just to feel when it touches. That's there. It's just gripping it. So now I know that that drill is 3 thou, this is a 3 thou feeler gauge, it's 3 thou off the edge of the bar. I know the diameter of the centre drill is 0.116 and I know the diameter of the part is 0.253 inches. So I'll lift this up now, knowing that it's 3 thou off the edge, bring it in 3 thou. So I know now that the cutter is on the edge. Wind it in half the diameter, which is 0.126. And then half the cutter, which is 0.058. That should put that drill in the centre of the bar. Drill should be big enough to fit over the dial indicator. So now I want to drill another hole on the other, this one goes through where the two flats are, another hole here to go through for the locking screw. Done is drilled halfway through the thread so that the threads on the bottom side is full, and when I put the slot in, I've put the slot to one side so I've got more thread on the bottom for the cap head to grip.
I always remember what my metalwork teacher told me when I was at school when soldering: fish and chips frying tonight. Fish: fit the parts and check that the parts fit okay. Chips: clean the surface to be soldered. Frying: flux the parts to be soldered. Tonight, tin, add a layer of solder to the surface. Now I want to fix the ball with solder into the hole on the end. So the first thing I need to do is put some flux in there, heat it up, and then tin the joint with some solder.
If I heat that up again, it should solder on. Take that out. And all I've got to do is some emery cloth, just take off the solder. Let's run down the side, clean it up a bit, that's finished. Often you need to check both the outside and the inside. Now that would normally involve changing the dial indicator to a lever type to get in, or an attachment on the dial indicator to be able to put a probe into the bore. So now what I've done with this, you can just turn this out, stays in the upright position normally, and when you need it, just turn it round. Using the Allen key, just nip it up. Then you can go into the bore without having to change your dial indicator and check the runout on the inside of the bore. Obviously you have to go to the back of the bore so that the runout is pushing the indicator in and out. You can't do it on the front, otherwise it'd try pulling the indicator. And that's got a tooth air run out. Turn it to the upright position, which has got a tooth air run out. Move it out, turn the attachment round, just tighten it up, move it to the bore, obviously the closer this ball is to the stem, the more accurate it will be. You will get a bit of spring in this, depending on how much play you've got in the spindle.
Well, that's it for today. I hope that was useful, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.